Today, we will review how to edit or create new email templates in Sage Intacct. In Intacct, we can add email templates to create an organized email content to fit your company requirements. We can create a variety of email templates and use them for different types of transactions. We can also make the content of emails dynamic by adding merge fields such as vendor's name, invoice number, purchase order date, contact information, and so on. To view, add, or modify the email templates list, go to Company, Setup tab, Settings, Email Templates. Let's edit one on the bottom. Email template screen has three segments. General information on the top contains fields, required field name, so pick something descriptive, easy to pick through the workflow. Same thing with description. Template type, this is a very important area. Email templates can be associated with one of the seven predefined transaction types. They can be assigned to AR invoices, AR statements, contracts. So this area here, contracts, is not really applicable to the majority of Sage Intacct construction clients. It is used for the management of recurring revenue with emphasis on subscription-based method of billing, so really not applicable for majority of construction companies out there. Order entry transactions, this part would cover project billing. Purchasing transaction covers PO, PO requisition, subcontracts. And finally, two different templates can be assigned to the change management process, one for to the change request, so email is going upstream and downstream, so to the owner or vendor subcontractor. And finally, project change order, so that's the email template attached to the owner change order document. Next decision we have to make once we pick our template type is if we're going to include all documents as attachment in the email. If you select this box, all documents that are attached to transactions will be included in email. So that includes document, in this case it would be either PO or subcontract, plus any other attachments I may have attached to the document. Please note that by selecting this option, all those documents will be included every time you send email using this template option. We also have an option to display dates in the user preference settings, so date format can be set up by user, and this particular template has option to allow us to use user preferences in terms of date format for sending emails out. Next segment, addresses. You'll see that we're using a combination of hard-coded, static information, and dynamic information. So my reply to address and reply to name is a static. It's a hard-coded in this template. So any email coming back from recipient that they reply to will be coming to this email address. However, my to field is using merged field. So this field is coming from the database. It's going to change as the vendor information changes, of course. So how are we going to find which fields to use here? How are we going to find what kind of information we need to enter here? If you click on a question mark, top right-hand corner of the screen, it will open a help article that has a related information on it. Scroll down and look for a hyperlink called Merge Fields for Email Templates. If you click on it and scroll a little bit down, you'll find a list of all possible fields or available fields that can be used in any of those seven predefined template types. So this is correct syntax for the field that you're looking for. So in this case, we picked up contact email address field associated with the PO document. If you scroll further down to message contact segment, you'll see that we have more of those merge fields being used in an email template. One of them would pull document number, which is a subcontact or PO number in a subject line. It will pull the company name, document number, document total, as well as a due date. It will also include my company name as a merge field. And finally, on the bottom, we have option to include the logo with our signature line and position that logo on the bottom left in this case. So let's save this information and let's see how we're going to use those templates now in the system. This particular template that we just edited down on the bottom is associated with purchasing transactions. So if you go to purchasing, setup, configuration, and then click on documents configuration tab, we can assign that template to a particular item or documents in this particular module. So for subcontracts, line number 6, we can assign particular email template to be default template for that type of document. So let's pick number 1, email subcontract. Now we have an option to override this on a fly as we're using a document, or we can associate a template with particular vendor, which would supersede settings in a purchasing module. So if I go to accounts payable, pick the vendor, and let's pick one of them. Let's take Alpha Installation. If you go to Additional Information tab, scroll to the bottom, we have option to assign email template to this particular vendor. And this is where we can override that global setting from the purchasing. So we can assign different email template for this particular vendor for that particular document. So let's review the impact of those setup changes. Let's go to subcontracts and let's open one of the existing subcontracts. This one is assigned to vendor Alpha Installation. You'll notice that there's an attachment being added to this document. This attachment is a quotation that we sent out, accepted, and now we're attaching this quotation to the subcontract document. Also, once we email this out, additional attachment would be actual subcontract document. Email addresses all came through, and we have a content of subcontract down our bottom. There's a schedule of values. If you click on print or email and select email checkbox, this portion of the screen will display email header. It will give us a preview of PDF attachment, which is a subcontract document. So in this case, this is my doc template being attached to subcontracts. And we have this quotation attachment also being attached to the document. We have from email addresses in place, and my email template is now specified. So notice that this email is now pulling from a vendor setup file. I still have an option to override template with something else on a fly as I'm sending this email out. By clicking OK, this email will be queued for emailing. So let's have a look at that email. So this is my email going out, 2 attachments. And this is a content of the email template. If you remember, we had a dynamic fields here. This is a company information. This is a subcontract number. And in summary, we have a total amount of subcontract and a due date with my signature down on the bottom. So this was a quick review on how to edit, view, or create new email templates in Sage Intacct. Thank you for watching.